everyone. Welcome to Molly's Kitchen. Today I'll be preparing spring rolls. It's my mom's recipe. So I have a bowl here with, I already put some ground turkey breasts. Now spring rolls is very delicious with ground pork. But today I chose chicken breast, about a pound's worth. And we are going to put 1 cup of chopped carrots, 1 cup of sweet onion, and I'm actually going to cut some veggies here for you. So you want to do at least 2 potatoes, so about small sized potatoes, and chop it up real nice. The other 2 vegetables that I put in there, I actually use the food processor, so, but what's a cooking show without chopping something? So I am going to chop these guys up for you. Usually about 1 potato is good, but I just peeled out an extra one just in case I need it. But anyways, very, very simple. These spring rolls are what I make for parties, when I bring something to eat at a friend's house or something like that. They usually request spring rolls or pad thai. So just depending on how I feel that day, or if I had enough time, I'll be preparing these. Now these spring rolls do freeze nicely if they're small. We're gonna be making the big ones. What I found is that if you do the big ones, freeze them, and then you thaw it out, the paper, the wrapping paper actually cracks. So, but the smaller ones, it's actually very, very easy to do. Very, very easy to do. So, anywho, this is my topping here. I've got a little bit of Kenny G in the background, like some music. You guys like Kenny G? I do. Anyways, so chop it up real nice, just like that. Very small, tiny. All goes in the bowl here. And then you're gonna add a little bit of oyster sauce, the oyster sauce that I posted in my Facebook page, just a little bit like this. That's probably about a tablespoon. We also have my chicken base, about 2 teaspoons. You also want to add some black pepper, just a little bit, 1 egg, and then I've already soaked the black fungus, which is actually mushrooms, and versamil mung bean noodles. So for a pound of ground beef, you want to use about a cup worth of these guys, and they turn out to be like this, and I'll chop it up and show you. This here, you want to use 2 bundles for a pound. And there's that. How I like to do these, I just take some kitchen shears, just chop it up. About 1/2 inch or so, just so when you bite into into the spring roll, you don't have a long noodle coming out of your mouth from it. Goes in there. And then I'm gonna chop these guys. So the texture on these, when you put them in there in the water, is hard. They're dehydrated. So afterwards, when it's soaked, it's nice and soft. So you want to rinse those up. Again, we're gonna slice it. Now these are optional. I don't cook these for my brother. He can't have any mushroom like this. He's way highly allergic than me. I use a small cutting board because I can turn it like this. Chop it all up here. Again, I'm not a professional, but like I said, I'm trying to keep it real for you guys because we're not all chefs at home. Of course, we like to believe we are. There we go. All nice and chopped. And that's all the ingredients I'm putting. And then I have these gloves to mix with. So you can see mixing. So you guys can see here how it looks. Now you might want to add however you like it. You might want to add some salt, but the chicken base already has the saltiness into it, and the sugar, the oyster sauce already has that sweet taste to it. That's why I only put those two in everything I make when I cook and prepare meals. These gloves are falling off here. And then really, really well, you want to mix it all up. You can definitely use your hands. You see my gloves are falling off here. Okay. So what I like to do is take a little piece of meat in a little plate and microwave it, and I taste it. And then that's how I know that the mixture inside the spring roll is perfect. Okay, so I've already put a little piece in the microwave like this. You kind of want to taste your batter just to make sure it tastes okay. 30 seconds or so in the microwave. Ooh. Perfect. Now, we're going to wrap.